Hi, welcome to this video. Let's see how to build 3D projects in ArchiCAD 18. Leave us comments to improve our videos. All you need to build 3D projects is inside Design section in the toolbox. ArchiCAD is mainly focused on buildings and houses. However, this is a basic tutorial. You will need practice and experience to start making professional projects and get to know everything this software offers for 3D projects. Check out the link in video description to see a very easy and basic house design. Let's start with the visualization tools. There are different ways to check your 3D projects, lots listed in the Navigator palette. The first way is to use the elevations. By default, you have four of them: north, south, east, and west. Each one is indicated through a blue segment, named and oriented through an arrow. So, when you click on an elevation, you will see your project from its point of view, indicated by its own arrow, and so the others. In each elevation view, different height levels are indicated. These are called stories, and normally do separate the different floors of a building. Remember that the current view selected is indicated by a blue contour in the Navigator palette. You can also create new points of view by editing elevations or creating new ones. You can edit elevations as normal objects, changing their point of view by rotating them and changing their length. Make sure to have elevations sufficiently long to cover all your project, or it will show up incomplete. You can rename it by right-clicking on it in the Navigator palette, and you can create new ones simply copying and pasting an existing one. The second way is to use the stories. These will show your project always from up to down, depending on the story chosen from the Navigator palette. You can see them very well in any of the elevation views. Stories do fix a determined height in your project. Mind that some properties may be linked to them. So, changing the height of a story will change the height of its objects linked, that you can check by hovering objects for some time, so be careful. You can rename stories by right-clicking on them and going to Rename Story. To create new ones instead, just right-click on Stories and go to Create New Story. Then fix name and height at which it appears in the elevation views. The third way is the 3D visualization, which is a 3D full preview. You can enable it going on 3D window in the standard bar. Always use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out, and the pen tool to check your project. Moreover, if you press the letter O from your keyboard, you can use the Orbit command that lets you check your project in full 3D. Press O again or use Escape key to exit. You can also use the Explore command. This lets you see your project in deep, as it could be in reality. Check the instructions in the first window to learn how to use it. You can also use perspective views just double-click on the subsections of 3D in the Navigator palette. Let's see how to build a simple 3D project. You can use any of the views seen, an elevation view, a story one, or a 3D one. Experience will tell you which is the best one to use case by case. Two tools lets you build a generic 3D object, the Morph and the Mesh tool. The Morph tool lets you draw 2D objects in a 3D space. This is very different from standard 2D tools. In 3D space, you can't use any tool from the document section, and plus, standard 2D objects never appear in any of the 3D previews we have seen, apart from story views. Indeed, the ones created with the Morph tool do appear in any case. This works just as seen inside a 2D project, creating paths or enclosed polygons and curves. The only difference is that you don't have just the X and Y axes, but also the Z axis that fixes the height. You can draw along their directions if these are highlighted in yellow. If you are drawing on a story, this will show up in blue. ArchiCAD does help you showing the current plane you are drawing on. If it is horizontal, you will draw fixing the height. If the grid is vertical, you are drawing changing the height too. This is enforced with the small gray plane on your pointer. All the rest is identical: the axis directions, the starting point, the dialog box with distance and angle information, the red points to show off guidelines, and so on. Undo drawing using Escape key. Make selections using the arrow tool and use your keyboard to set precise values. In this case, the Z coordinate may not be zero. So you can draw lines and paths, clicking on the last fixed point, or 2D closed paths and polygons, in 3D called surfaces. Also in 3D views, it's important the shape your pointer shows. Check marks for vertices, a star for edges, and vertical bars for medians, as always. Moreover, if you are fixing a point on a face, your pointer becomes a rhombus with a cross inside. Let's see how to edit a Morph object to create any personalized 3D object. As always, you need to select it first and then click on a node, a path, or a face. If you click on a node, you can find again Move Node, Drag, Fillet, Chamfer, Offset All Edges, Mirror, and Rotate, equal to the 2D ones seen, even if their icons are different. Plus you have new tools, important to transform in 3D. One is called Tube, and lets you create 3D conductors taking as sections the original surface you have. This can be used to add an initial extrusion. Just make sure to finish by clicking when the pencil is black on the Cartesian origin. Box stretch makes you scale and skew the virtual box that contains the surface. The pencil lets you add more surfaces, linked to the one you have. Don't use this to make 3D projects, prefer tube instead. If you click on a path, you find other tools met in 2D projects, plus others already seen. If you click on a face, you can use bulge to apply irregular surfaces, and push-pull to add a simple direct extrusion. When you want to edit a 3D object, nothing changes. All the transformation tools seen work in the same way. You will just find two new transformations, which are the 3D fillet chamfer ones. In short, if you click on a node or on an edge, you can fillet or chamfer such in 3D. The transformations that come from the faces are identical to the ones seen for a surface. Mind that the transformations seen appear when in 3D view mode. If you are in a 2D view mode, like elevations or story views, you will see and use the classic transformations seen for 2D projects, apart from the Elevate tool. Don't forget that you can delete 3D objects by right-clicking on them and going to Delete. Also in 3D projects, you can use the advanced tools in the standard bar, with some small differences. For example, when using the Split tool, you won't define a simple line, but you must define a plane in red color. You first fix 2 points for the direction and a third one for the inclination. Then decide which side to select. Another important tool is the Mesh tool that makes you build 3D projects pretty fast, although with less control than with the Morph tool. ArchiCAD indeed helps you with lots and lots of templates, focused more on buildings and houses. You can use wall to build walls, doors to build door templates, and so with windows, stairs, roofs, and even domestic objects. All of these, except walls, are ready-made templates that you can choose going to Settings dialog in the info bar. Experience will guide you at using these options better. Moreover, these templates can be placed on determined objects. For example, you can place doors and windows just on walls. Always check your pointer. If it's a rhombus, it means that you can apply these templates. If it is a cross or a cloud, you can't. And each template can have its own transform tools that you can discover and learn with time. Practice. Keep in mind that any 3D ready-made template can be transformed into a morph object so that you can edit and personalize it fully. Just right-click on the template placed and go to Convert Selection to Morph. Mind that the object, once it is turned to Morph, may have a different Settings dialog window, so transform when you are ready. You can personalize it then. If you can't, remember to disable groups with suspend groups on top. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel to discover other amazing softwares.